وتعاونوا على البر والتقوى ولا تعاونوا على الإثم والعدوان واتقوا الله إن الله شديد العقاب.
تمسك بحبل الله واتبع الهدى ولا تك بدعيا لعلك تفلح ودن بكتاب الله والسنن التي أتت عن رسول الله.
As you will be joined by a new team of cabin crew who will take you on the second leg of your journey to
الفردوس بالنور تسرح سعيد وسعد وابن عوف وطلحة وعامر فهر والزبير الممدح وقل خير قول في الصحابة كلهم ولا تك طعانا تعيب وتجرح فقد نطق الوحي المبين بفضلهم وفي الفتح آي في الصحابة تمدح وبالقدر المقدور أيقن فإنه دعامة عقل الدين والدين أفيح ولا تنكرا جهلا نكيرا ومنكرا ولا الحوض والميزان إنك تنصح وقل يخرج الله العظيم بفضله من النار أجسادا من الفحم تطرح على النهر في الفردوس تحيا بمائه كحب حميل السيل إذ جاء يطفح وإن رسول الله للخلق شافع وإن عذاب القبر بالحق موضح ولا تكفرن أهل الصلاة وإن عصوا فكلهم يعصي وذو العرش يصفح ولا تعتقد رأي الخوارج إنه مقال لمن يهواه يردي ويفضح ولا تك مرجيا لعوبا بدينه ألا إنما المرجي بالدين يمزح وقل إنما الإيمان قول ونية.
الحمد لله. I met up with the brothers today at London, what is it? London what?
London Central Mosque.
London Central Mosque. Alhamdulillah, our brother Muhammad Bulhan.
Yeah,
our brother Muhammad Abdil Wali. And our brother here, Abshir. Alhamdulillah, all for the Shaykh Sulaymaan Ar Ruhayli's conference. The brothers are meeting up here in London. Everyone is excited. The Shaykh, Qadala Masha Fa'ala, he got delayed. So the program is shifted for 2 days in Birmingham, which begins on Saturday inshallah, and then 2 days in London, which is the following Monday and Tuesday. So alhamdulillah, today we're meeting up with all of the brothers. All of the brothers are here. We met up at this masjid here. Again, the brothers are saying this is London's
central mosque.
Alhamdulillah, beautiful masjid.
Built by Saudi Arabia.
So Muhammad Bulhan, he said, it was opened by?
It was built by Saudi Arabia.
Alhamdulillah. Alhamdulillah. And what's the park over there?
Regent's Park. Next door to Regent's Park.
And we passed by the London Zoo, right?
London Zoo. It's right next to the London Zoo too.
Alhamdulillah. We're not here for tourism, but we just met the brothers here, you know? And it's just a beautiful sight. Walillah alhamd. All of the greenery, the trees, the masjid.
There's always tourism in it.
Alhamdulillah. Muhammad, what's up, man? Give the brother salams, man.
Hayakallah. How are you?
Alhamdulillah, all is good. What's the advice for the brothers and sisters? Shaykh Sulaymaan
Ar Ruhayli, man. Just give my salam, man, and tune in, inshallah. Like,
let everyone come up, eh?
Tune in live,
come
yeah.
up.
Benefit, inshallah.
Abshir, what's the advice, man, for the conference? While the brother's eating, alhamdulillah. Say something good, man.
Inshallah, everyone attend the conference.
It's one opportunity, it doesn't happen every time. So inshallah, welcome everyone down to UK.
Alhamdulillah, just come out and benefit, yeah?
Yeah,
no. Let's take a look at the masjid, walk around. Allah is a beautiful sight, it's a beautiful feeling to be with the Muslims. Walillah alhamd, brothers traveling from different places, from Canada. I came from Trinidad. Brothers are coming in from New York. Brothers from different cities here in London, heading out to Birmingham. It's all good, alhamdulillah. For one thing, for the purpose of benefiting in the deen of Allah Azza wa Jal, Ahlul Sunnah wal Jama'ah, they're together, walillah alhamd. It's a big open area. Alhamdulillah, the dome. Lots of Muslims, walillah alhamd.
The top floor is a library. Top floor is facing us is a library.
The whole thing up there, yeah?
Yeah, up there.
Second floor. The whole thing is a library. Alhamdulillah. Okay, so alhamdulillah, the brothers brought me out to a park. What is the park called again?
Alexandra Palace.
Alhamdulillah.
Ya marhaba.
Ala kulli hal, it's just a beautiful view, alhamdulillah, you know.
Yeah.
A beautiful view. Good day out with the brothers. All praises are for Allah. Bismillah wa salatu wa salam ala nabiyyina Muhammad wa ala alihi wa sahabi. So with our brother Muhammad Bin Abdil Wali, and we want to request you inshallah on this day, alhamdulillah, we had a good time together today, to give us something of an advice, a reminder to the brothers and the sisters. With the fadl.
Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. Alhamdulillah Rabbil Alameen. Wa sallallahu wa sallam ala nabiyyina Muhammad wa ala alihi wa sahbihi ajma'in. Ahlan, welcome all my brothers and sisters from the Sid Tawheed. Spend some good time today with our brother Abdul Haq, mashallah. He came all the way here from that small island, Trinidad and Tobago, all the way here for just one reason, which is to benefit, to seek knowledge, to sit under the feet of the scholars. He came to attend the Dawr of Shaykh Sulaymaan Ar Ruhayli, hafizahullah ta'ala. Likewise, I came here to also attend and benefit from the Shaykh. So my advice really would be the same thing for all of you. Seek knowledge and benefit from the scholars as much as you can. Those of you that have the opportunity to travel and sit underneath the scholars, then of course that's what you should do, that's the asal. That's what, there's nothing like that. If you can't do that, then at least benefit from the scholars from wherever you are, by attending their durus online, by referring things back to them, and more importantly as well, by equipping yourself with those tools that you need in order to benefit from the scholars, such as learning the Arabic language, such as, you know, most importantly, learning the Arabic language, memorize the Quran, learn the ulum al-ala, such as usul al-fiqh, such as mustalah al-hadith, these tools that you need in order to understand the speech of the scholars, in order to benefit from them. That would be my advice. Knowledge, knowledge, knowledge. Just like Shaykh Muhammad bin Abdul Wahhab, rahimahullah ta'ala, said in his famous book, Al-Usul al-Thalatha, I'lam, rahimahullah, annahu yajibu alayna ta'allumu arba'i masail. Al-Ula al-ilm, al-amal bih, wa-da'watu ilayh, wa-sabru al-adhafih. He said that you have to know that it is wajib upon every Muslim and every Muslimah to learn four things, wajib upon all of us. First thing is al-ilm, knowledge. Just like Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, فَعْلَمْ أَنَّهُ لَا إِلَهَ إِلَّا اللَّهِ. Know that there is no deity worthy of worship except Allah. So even for your tawheed, the reason which Allah has created you for, to worship Him alone, your tawheed needs to be based upon knowledge. That's the tawheed. So how about everything else? And then after knowledge, you act upon that knowledge that you have. you act upon it, and then you call people to it, you share it. And you're patient upon that, you keep that going, all three things. You keep on seeking knowledge, you keep on acting upon it, you keep on calling to it, and you keep the cycle going. These four things wajib upon all of us. So every single one of us, my dear brothers and sisters, has to take the steps today, not tomorrow. You have to take the steps today to equip yourself with beneficial Islamic knowledge. All of us work hard, all of us take the steps to equip ourselves with that which we need for our daily sustenance. We go to school, we go to college, we go to university. But I want you to remember this hadith from the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, where he said, "Inna Allah yubghidu kulla 'alimin bid-dunya jahilin bil-akhirah." Allah is angry with anyone who's a scholar when it comes to the worldly affairs, but at the same time an ignoramus, or ignorant when it comes to al-akhirah, the hereafter. So there's nothing wrong with seeking secular knowledge and seeking and acquiring those things that help you with your sustenance. وَلَا تَنْسَ نَصِيبَكَ مِنَ الدُّنْيَا, like Allah said, do not forget your portion from this world. But what's not praiseworthy and what makes Allah angry with you is when you spend all your time seeking your worldly benefit and at the same time you ignore your akhirah by not seeking knowledge and by not being someone who knows at least the minimum that you need to know. There's a certain level of knowledge that every Muslim has to have. If you don't have that level of knowledge, then you have no excuse on the day of judgment if you are capable of seeking that knowledge. Oh Allah, I didn't know wouldn't be an excuse for you if you had the ability to seek that knowledge. So knowledge such as al-ibadat, your worship, such as your wudu, your tahara, your salah, how to perform hajj, how to fast the month of Ramadan, and what breaks the fast, and these sort of things, everything to do with your worship, specifically the five pillars of al-Islam. And before that, of course, everything to do with your aqidah, what you believe in the hereafter, your belief with regards to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and His angels and His messengers and His books and the day of judgment and al-qadr and all of the arkan of al-iman. You have to have knowledge of these things. And also the other things that you need in your daily life, such as if you're someone who runs a business, there's a certain level of knowledge that you have to know before you can buy and sell. For those of you that want to get married, there's a certain level of knowledge that you need to have before you tie the knot. For those of you, for example, all the other yani mu'amalat, they call it, when it comes to transactions, when it comes to fiqh al-usra as well, there are certain things that you have to know according to your need. So if you have the ability to seek knowledge, if you have the ability to benefit from the scholars, you have to know that time is of the essence. And you never know, death could be around the corner. There could be things that you're doing right now that are haram, that you don't know they are haram. Even when it comes to shirk, Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam said that shirk, Ibn Abbas radiallahu anhu said that the shirk is akhfa min dabib al-namli ala safatin sawta fi dhulmati al-layl. Shirk is harder to see shirk, and it's more hidden than a black ant on a black rock in the darkness of the night. That's why there's a dua that you should always say, which is Allahumma inni a'udhu bika an ushrika bika wa ana a'lam wa astaghfiruka min adhanbi alladhi la a'lam. Oh Allah, I seek refuge in you that I commit shirk knowingly. And I seek your forgiveness for any shirk that I might fall into that I have no knowledge of, but out of ignorance. This shows us that even shirk, that one crime that Allah Ta'ala doesn't forgive. Yes, all of us are people of tawheed. We want to die upon tawheed. But the thing that nullifies tawheed, which is shirk, it is hidden. It is hidden. There are certain aspects of shirk that are very intricate. Now, if you don't take the time and you don't put in the effort to seek knowledge such that you know the different types of shirk so that you can avoid it, then of course, if you fall then into those matters, then you are no one to blame but yourself. Yeah, so to conclude, that's my advice, my dear brothers and sisters. Seek knowledge, seek knowledge, seek knowledge. And before that, seek all of the means that you need in order to seek knowledge. I ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that allows all of us to seek knowledge and to benefit from the knowledge and to act upon that knowledge. Allahumma alimna ma yanfa'una wa anfa'na bima allamtana wa zidna ilma. Oh Allah, teach us that which will benefit us and benefit us with that which you have taught us. and increase us in knowledge. هذا والله أعلم صلى الله عليه وسلم على نبينا محمد.
جزاك الله خيرا.
بارك الله فيك.
حياكم الله جميعا.
فإن كلام الله باللفظ يوضح وقل يتجلى الله للخلق جهرة كما البدر لا يخفى وربك أوضح وليس بمولود وليس بوالد وليس له شبه تعالى المسبح وقد ينكر الجهمي هذا وعندنا بمصداق ما قلنا حديث مصرح رواه جرير عن مقال محمد فقل مثل ما قد قال في ذاك تنجح وقد ينكر الجهمي أيضا يمينه وكلتا يديه بالفواضل تنفح وقل ينزل الجبار في كل ليلة بلا كيف جل الواحد المتمدح إلى طبق الدنيا يمن بفضله فتفرج أبواب السماء وتفتح